Hi, my name is Amy Stedman, and this is my 850 Module 14 School Law. To summarize the case study, we have a first-year teacher, Miss Tate. She is hired on at a prestigious and affluent school. She definitely has high expectations for her students. She has specialized science courses that she teaches, including a course like zoology. And the rigor of her subjects and her serious approach to her delivery is working on or is increasing the student's stress level. And parents have called and spoke with Dr. Smith, the principal, and he has discussed her teaching style with him, though it hasn't changed, and so there's still some concern there. Miss Tate receives an email later on, leading her to a Facebook page with an indirect death threat that is posted. And so, as far as what we know about our case study at this time, we have a high school with affluence. It's an affluent school. We have trendy students within the high school, and our principal is Dr. Harvey Smith. He is an established principal. He has been there 9 years. Within the past 2 years, he was the principal of the year by the state, and it is noted that he wants to maintain his reputation. He is liked by his parents. He also works diligently to hire the most highly qualified educators. Now, as far as our parents, we know that they are respectful of the principal. They are affluent themselves. They are worried that their children will make their first low grade in school in Mrs. Tate's class because of their stress level and how well they're doing academically at this time. Additionally, we know that Miss Tate herself is a first-year teacher. She has a serious approach to her instructional delivery. She has stringent expectations. She is not implementing Dr. Smith's suggested techniques for reducing the student's stress, so there's some concern there. And there is an increasing, or excuse me, he was working on student stress and increasing positive interactions with the students. Additionally, we know that she was sent an email from an unknown sender with a link, and the link was to a Facebook page. There were comments on the page that were very critical in regards to rigor in her class, and then there were also some suggestive comments about her personal life. And then a final note was at the bottom that said, "Who wants Miss Tate to disappear?" This terrified Miss Tate, as it would me as well, and she informed the principal. He felt like it was a prank. And she jumped to name a student, and they kind of did a little bit of assuming. And then they discussed addressing it with the student the next day. So I feel like there's a lot that is left to be told in this story. What specifically has been said to the principal and to the teacher, I have an interest in knowing. I want to know what has been said by the students and by the parents. And it really doesn't sound like the parents have gone to Miss Tate with their concerns. It sounds like they've gone straight to the principal, which is yet another problem. And I also want to know why this incident wasn't reported to police. It is criminal activity. I'm not sure why they did not go that direction. I have an assumption. And then, the police have some digital tracking methods where they could have figured this out very easily, I believe. Doing what was done with a death threat is illegal, and the case definitely should have been started with the local police department. I also want to know what strategies Dr. Smith shared with Miss Tate to aid with her students. Why wasn't she receptive of this? And so, did she hear his suggestions? Did she understand the situation? Did he explain the situation and the parents' concerns clearly enough? And then I also like to know what other supports for Miss Tate might exist. She is a new teacher. It wasn't noted if she had a mentor or not. And then I also want to know if Dr. Smith has considered some professional development opportunities for her. Now, as far as problems, I think we have a few on our hands here. One, Miss Tate does have high expectations for her students, which isn't necessarily a problem, but it's the fact that these kids are struggling and the parents are continually calling the principal, that creates the issue. I think that it's okay to have high expectations of students. I have very, very high expectations of my students, and I understand that parents don't want their students failing. But I also think that at some point we need to figure out how to find a good balance. The students are starting to make snide comments, and Dr. Smith has made suggestions to her, and he feels that they've gone unrecognized, or it was noted in the case study that they've gone unrecognized. And so, how to balance this out seems to be a concern. Additionally, the indirect threat was made on Miss Tate, and since it was sent to her, somebody wanted her to know about this. And so that is definitely a big problem. And then I also find it a problem personally that the police report wasn't filed. Dr. Smith said, "I'll just take care of it tomorrow and we'll talk to that student." And, considering Miss Tate is a first-year teacher, I'm sure she just went along with it and felt secure in her principal's decisions. She did obviously want to leave town. down for the night, and I don't blame her for that, but I also would have left town and gone to the principal or gone to the police if it was me. And it doesn't sound like she did that. Additionally, Miss Tate has pinpointed a student who she feels did this, and I think that that can also be kind of damaging to walk in with that kind of bias. As far as an action with some strategies and steps, I think that they definitely should have called the police to file a report. Like I noted, technology does exist and they could have figured all this out. I also think that they need to follow proper protocol according to state law, which would be once a death threat or criminal activity has occurred, it really should have been taken out of the hands of the school and managed by the local authorities, but it was not. The principal then has to notify the superintendent. It was also noted, and I put in my own district's board policies, that the Board of Education prohibits bullying in any form by any student, staff member, or parent towards another student or staff member while on school property or using school devices. So, if this had happened in our district and the student was using our school-issued devices, because we do have those at middle school and high school, that student would be in even further trouble, even on a local level with our Board of Education. Now, it was also noted, though, that the students in the community have the newest technology available to them, so there's definitely a good chance that they weren't using student, or school-issued devices. They were using their own devices, to be able to relay such media through, the internet. Additionally, I think, another part of my plan would be that if we don't involve police, which I do believe heavily that we should, then when you discuss with students, you should begin with William Hall. But don't accuse. We need to ensure that there's definitely no malice within the conversation. And then I do believe that whichever student did it, there is actual malice that has occurred. The person offended must demonstrate that the person making the offensive comment had a motive for doing so, and that the motive was calculated to generate ill will against the offended person. And it does sound like they have done something, and they personally feel like they have reason to do something if it was a student or a parent. I think that there is some data there that shows that they have been angered by Miss Tate and her approaches to teaching, and some threats have been made publicly. Additionally, I think that it has to be noted that wrongfully detaining a student for an unreasonable amount of time for offensive behavior that does not warrant detention constitutes a tort, but I don't feel like pulling the student aside for a few minutes to discuss this issue crosses any boundaries as far as that goes. School personnel must have a reasonable basis for confining a student, which they definitely do. If they're going to pull a student out of class to talk about this, or if they're going to keep a student after school to talk about this, it is definitely justified, and according to our text, it definitely has been supported. They're allowed to detain students after school if the offense is clearly one that warrants detention, and I definitely think, what has happened in our case is definitely one of those. Why they didn't call the police to handle it that way, I'm not quite sure. I feel like that is definitely something that should have happened, but if they feel like it is just a joke or a prank and they're deciding to manage it on their own for some reason, they are definitely allowed to speak with the students in regards to such. Additionally, I think we need to provide Miss Tate with support on student relationships. She needs some professional development, possibly, to be able to read her students a little better. I think we need to pair her up with a mentor, work on some curricular expectations, and working on helping students reduce their stress levels. As far as promoting the academic success and personal well-being of every student involved, I think that if we increase support and training for Miss Tate, it would definitely take some of the burden off of all of the parties involved. I think it's okay to have our students struggle a little bit. What we don't want is them shutting down. I also think that we need to ensure a safe and secure learning environment for everyone. And the text also states that the school administrator, in conjunction with teachers, is definitely responsible for maintaining a safe and orderly learning environment where teachers teach and the students learn. And so I think that Dr. Smith definitely needs to consider that because it is his job to do so. I also think we need to consider a possible leave of absence for Miss Tate to keep her protected because she is not going to be well after feeling as if she has her life threatened. And there's a good chance that somebody actually may take action. And so, with that being the case, they definitely should follow through with police. As far as my problem debriefing, my thoughts, my feelings, and things I valued, I am definitely concerned on why the principal didn't call the police. I feel like, personally though, and personal opinion, I feel like he wants to manage his community and uphold his status. It was noted that he's very focused on maintaining a reputation as principal of the most prestigious school in the state. And I think that he wants to maintain his status with his parents. They are affluent families, and I think he likes that situation and that status, and I think he's very much so focusing on upholding his reputation. But I also think that he's doing at the cost of not keeping the best interest of his staff in mind, and I think that he definitely needs to consider his staff and Miss Tate just a little more in this situation, especially in regards to how this case is being handled. I think that Miss Tate needs to know that she has some support. What we have provided within the case is pretty vague. We don't know whether or not she has a mentor. We don't know what professional development she has had, but we do know that she has her bachelor's and her master's, and she has done some grad work, but that she also clearly is not necessarily struggling with classroom management, but she is struggling with making connections with her kids and knowing how stringent her class needs to be. And personally, yet again, another thought. It sounds like the parents kind of run the school just a little bit. I feel like that's what's going on in this situation, and I think that Dr. Smith kind of lets them because he likes his status. As far as promoting the success of every student by acting with integrity, it is noted that integrity is the quality of being honest and having strong moral principles. I think that Dr. Smith wants only the best staff for his stakeholders, and it was noted that he worked diligently to recommend only the most highly qualified teacher applicants for his available positions. And so that shows you that he definitely wants the best staff for his students, which is great. And I also think that it's nice that he worked to support Miss Hall by himself, but at the same time, I think that there's a lot of learning that comes with collaboration. And I want to know why she doesn't have a mentor or why she doesn't have people to collaborate with and why he's working on this himself. It is noted that he discussed techniques with Miss Tate to reduce the stress level of his students or of her students. And then it's also noted that I personally feel like if we have to interview students without police, even though I think that we should involve them, I think that he wanted to uphold the integrity of students and families and interview the students himself. And he wants to discuss with Ms. Hall. I think that they need to make sure that they don't accuse students, but I don't think that's going to happen. It doesn't seem like he wants his families upset. He had noted that in the morning, you and I will just need to speak with William and some of his friends who may know if he developed this site. And so he almost makes it come across as a casual conversation, but that he still wants to get to the bottom of it. As far as promoting the success of every student by acting with fairness is the impartial and just treatment or behavior without favoritism or discrimination. Now, I personally don't think that he was fair when he chose not to call the police, and I think that by not calling them, he was definitely not being fair with Miss Tate. She has a right to be protected. We know that he works to maintain his reputation, though, and many parents called Dr. Smith to complain. They never noted parents talking to Miss Tate specifically. And I think that in all fairness, he should have asked the parents if they'd ever spoken with the teacher in regards to their concerns before they went to the higher up. And instead, they just went to him, it sounds like. And so I don't know that that's very fair. It wasn't fair for Miss Tate. And maybe that's why she didn't adjust, is maybe because Dr. Smith maybe came in with bias. Maybe he wasn't listening to her entirely to figure out her side of the story and how she was struggling and figuring out what she needed. Maybe he was just coming at it from one angle, which was the parents. It is also noted that I feel like she was a little unfair when she jumped to conclusions with this student. When the police or district could have easily determined the source of the threats and emails, she said, "I know it's this student." I think that they definitely should have called the police so that they could be fair, and they should have done the interview with the students, as it is a criminal activity at this point, and the police should have been involved in those interviews. As far as promoting success of every student with an ethical manner, I think that ethics relates to the moral principles or the branch of knowledge that deals with those. Dr. Smith works really hard to protect his title over his teachers. He didn't advise Miss Tate not to call the police, but he didn't recognize or address that she probably should have. He immediately wanted to handle it himself the next day. He didn't advise parents to go discuss with Miss Tate themselves when they were concerned. He took all the calls and he worked to support her to help reduce the student stress levels all by himself. I think that it definitely could have been a collegial approach. And then Being that Miss Tate was a first-year teacher, she kind of went along with the guidance that she was given, and I think that maybe it should have been a little more broader in spectrum. So that is my case study reflection, and I really enjoyed doing this. I had a lot of things to say after that. And as far as references, I did use my Board of Education policies, I did use our text, and then I also used the case study. Thank you so much. Have a great day.